Well, from on-field violence to a tennis pro bored at Wimbledon and a footy star revealing his mental health battle. It's been a tumultuous week in Australian sport. So to delve a little deeper, I'm joined by sports psychologist Shayne Hanks. Welcome, Shayne.
Thank you.
Let's begin with two major incidents of on-field violence. Tom Bugg's punch that knocked out Callum Mills and, of course, Ali Fahour's life ban for punching an opposition player. What goes through an athlete's head before a brain snap like this?
So different incidents, but I think with the Bug incident, he has a reputation as being a bit of a serial pest. I think he was trying to aggravate the other player, and I think he probably went too far. I think he probably just went too far. I think the Fahour, anger is normally driven by a sense of violation of rights. But that may not have been that particular incident. That may have been previous incidents in the game or in his life. But that's the real, his is the real concern, because that was an unprovoked attack.
Mm. And
that
so was he looks very amped up at the time, and he sort of comes in around, and then afterwards he's almost looking around as an, I don't know, like the aggression's still there.
Yeah, he was looking for the next target.
Mm. Mm. And do you think had someone been close by, he might have actually hit another person?
Absolutely. I think he was looking for someone else, and he wasn't even aware of the impact of what he'd done.
And yeah, what do you think is causing these sort of brain snaps?
So, look, I mean, I think there's a lot in life that seems to be making people angrier, and they take that on the sporting field and they see that as an outlet.
Okay. Do you think incidents like these are common, or is it just our attitude has changed towards them?
I think that they have probably become more common. There is still a sense that the sporting field is an acceptable place to vent our anger, and it's just not. And I think that society has become less tolerant of that overall.
Okay. Let's move on to tennis pro Bernard Tomic, who's admitted he's bored with the game and is just doing it for the money. He suffered a huge backlash. Mm. How do you tell if it's, I guess, a mental health issue, or he's just a millennial and he's just plain obnoxious?
So, look, I think perhaps neither. In his case, it's damned if you do, damned if you don't. So we get a lot of cliches from athletes. When he's actually spoken up, he's been condemned for it. But, look, I think if he doesn't have a motivation and desire to play the game, he needs to take a break, and he needs to have a plan about what that will look like and how he'll return to the game. My concern is with him is that he put in a couple of years where he worked really hard, didn't get the results, and I wonder now if he's thinking that he is not as good as he maybe thought he always was.
Okay. So yesterday, Bulldog star Tom Boyd took leave from the AFL, we're just going into something else now, to deal and receive treatment for clinical depression. Do you think we're putting too much pressure on our athletes?
I think there is a lot of pressure on athletes more broadly, and that's because of the fame and because of the money and because of the exposure. I don't think there's a direct link between pressure and clinical depression, as in the Boyd case. So I think in that instance, you know, what we understand about depression is that it's an issue with brain chemistry, and it's unlikely that it's related or linked to a particular episode or event in his case, or it could be. So I think that's a different thing than players experiencing pressure and burnout and fatigue and those other things. I think depression is another matter entirely.
Yeah, what about, you talk about exposure, what about things like social media?
I think that's a huge trigger for both depression and anxiety. I think certainly a younger generation are very much more exposed and interested and involved in social media, and because of that, I think that they are more triggered by it, it's more meaningful, it has more direct consequences to them and to their peer group.
Mm, okay. And for someone who might be a parent or a friend of an athlete, who, I guess, what are those warning signs that they might be struggling for any of these things?
Yeah, so look, I think anxiety and depression are both very common. So a loss of enjoyment associated with the sport or with things more broadly that they had pleasure doing in the past, feelings of fatigue, obviously feelings of sadness or feeling down that persist over time, and also that will have implications in terms of appetite and sleep and so forth. So there are a number of things around that. We're really looking for changes out of the normal, but particularly around that persistent down state and a loss of enjoyment around things that they would have done previously. And if that's the case, then I'd encourage them to have a discussion around what might be causing that and look to see a health professional.
Okay. Shayne Hanks, thanks very much for your insight.
You're
and thanks
welcome.
For coming onto the show this afternoon.
Thank you.